Hey guys, it's Dagan from PMT in Newcastle here, and I have a very special guest today. It's Steve from Blackstar.
Hey guys, how you doing?
With the new Artist 30 amp. So Steve, tell me about the new Artist range.
Okay Dagan, well basically there's two amps. It's a brand new line for us. It's really exciting because it's a new valve product. Mm-hmm. For the past 3 years or so, we've concentrated very much on the digital side of things with ID Core, ID, ID Core Beam and Fly. So it's a larger amp, it's more powerful. This one in particular is the 2x12 30 watt, and then we have a 15 watt 1x12 as well.
Cool, cool.
The features include two channels, and we'll go through it just a little bit for you. It's a top loading amp, so it's very vintage and boutique looking.
Yeah, it does look very cool.
Yeah, which matches its sound really.
Yeah.
The first channel is just simple volume and tone, and it works in the circuitry with the power amp tubes. Mm-hmm. There's no preamp saturation in there, so it's very, very clean. Unless you're pushing a high output pickup on your guitar. The second channel, we have gain and volume, and then we have our three band EQ, bass, middle, treble, and then Blackstar's patent ISF, so you can find your British or American style tone
stack.
Yeah. Then we have global controls for reverb and master volume as well.
Brilliant.
Essentially, it's very, very clean all the way through. It's a perfect platform for pedals. Mm-hmm. But if you do use channel two and push the gain up quite high, you are going to get some bite there.
Nice, chewy, bitey, yeah.
Yeah, but it is still very much a vintage sound.
Yeah. Right?
There's some modern features as well. So what Blackstar wanted to try and do is distill that heritage from our original Artisan range, which mm-hmm. came out in the beginning of Blackstar's life, in more of a PCB, non-handwired amplifier, a more affordable product. And because the Artisan is our go-to amp for our artists touring around the world, we decided to call this the Artist Amp. So it's a bit more of a readily available product.
Very cool.
Affordable. Yeah. Some other things to note as well, additional features, it uses 6L6 power amp valves. Mm-hmm. And then we've got a couple of ECC83s in the front end for your preamp.
Very nice.
So it's lending itself to more of an American style mm-hmm. tone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the fast loop as well?
Effects loop, yep. Yeah. So under the hood, we've got, on the back here, we've got effects loop for your modulations, delays mm-hmm. and stuff like that. We've got emulated line out so you can connect direct to a PA or record.
Very cool, very cool.
As well as miking up the front so you can take two signals from the amp, that's mm-hmm. really cool. And we've got reverb choice as well between dark reverb and light reverb, so it's a really versatile product.
Yeah.
With lots of modern features, but in a boutique design.
Yeah, and a boutique sound and feel.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Do you want to try and see how it sounds?
Yeah, of course, man. Cool. It certainly feels like boutique when you're playing it. Yeah, you get that kind of really responsive, percussive kind of vibe.
Yeah.
It's very cool.
Cool. Okay, so Dagan, do you want to try channel one?
Of course,
see
man,
how it feels.
Cool, let's give it a bash.
And we're just running volume and tone.
Cool. Cool. Yeah, very cool, man. Very clean, very impressive.
Yeah. And one thing to note as well is if you do push the volume mm-hmm. all the way, it still remains really clean, so it's mm-hmm. a great platform for pedals.
That is clean. That is very clean, yeah.
Lots of headroom.
Clean with volume is very hard to find these days.
Absolutely, yeah. So let's try the second channel.
Cool.
So now we have a bit more versatility, EQ, ISF, and gain and volume. So there's a bit more saturation when you push it, but we'll start with the gain around about 12 o'clock.
Cool, let's do that.
It's very vintage tones.
Very kind of.
It's going to appeal to the blues fans, mm-hmm. the kind of the rock and roll fans, the mm-hmm. rock fans. But of course, if you're playing high gain stuff, you can put anything in the front end.
Yeah, that's just dying to have some kind of boost on it just to tighten things up. Yeah,
Absolutely. So one thing you may have noticed there, if you were watching when Dagan went to his humbucker on the bridge there, you got a little bit more brittle. But if we push the gain even more so, if you could start off on the single coils again, sure. And then push it to the bridge a bit later through your demo.
So probably gets heads off.
Yeah, so this is gain up full.
Try this humbucker.
Cool. So it cleans up really well, and I've tried many guitars for it so far, 335, Strats, Les Paul, PRS, all kinds of stuff that we have at the office at Blackstar, and it handles everything really well.
Yeah,
and the nuances of those guitars all come through really well as well.
It's such a thick sound, but it's got that boutique mid-range poke, so it will cut through things.
Yeah,
with maintaining that thick sponginess.
While you're playing now, I'll move the ISF around as well so you can hear some tonal differences there as well. So at the moment we're starting on the British side of things, so it's all the way on.
So for the people, what does the ISF switch do again? Just for people that
so don't... ISF, yeah, if you've not heard of ISF before, it's a patent to Blackstar, and it's on the majority of our products. It stands for Infinite Shape Feature. And essentially, every voicing of any particular amplifier has a certain point in its sonic tone stack where there's a mid-dip that occurs, and it's different for every amplifier. Mm-hmm. And what ISF allows you to do is essentially have your three-band EQ, bass, middle, treble, and ISF is an overriding frequency control which moves all three frequencies, but more so the mids, where the mid-dip appears in the sonic scale. Mm-hmm. So it's a Blackstar's motto since day one has always been the sound in your head, and it's all about letting the guitar player find their own sound, rather than just having one EQ tone stack, one voice, mm-hmm. you know?
Total tone shaving capabilities.
Absolutely, yeah. And it's infinite, you know, from side to side.
Yeah, very cool.
Every room could be different. You know, if you want a bit of a tighter American sound, you know, a specific venue, or if you want a bit more of a low end pushed in a bigger venue, mm-hmm. it's all good.
That works great with this kind of amp as well.
Absolutely.
People love differentiating between old, like, F-style amps and F-style amps. Yeah.
Yeah. Very cool.
Very badass, man.
Cool.
Well, yeah, I think that's all the features, isn't it?
Excellent, yeah. I mean, it's got a nice, the black fret on the front there has got a nice silver thread in, which really sets it off nicely.
Yeah, you can see it shining in the light. It looks...
So on stage, these are all really pretty. a nice leather embossed strap. It's a beautiful product. And
little quirks as well, like the little Blackstar star on the handle. It just sets things off lovely.
Yeah, so we're hoping for good things for the artist range. So it's a 15-watt 1x12, 30-watt 2x12, using Celestion V-Types, 6L6s, perfect pedal amp.
Badass. Available at PMC now.